Hello and welcome friends to a lecture on address resolution protocol. These are the learning outcomes. By the end of this session, student will be able to first explain operation of ARP and second explain each field of ARP packet format. Before starting this topic, you may pause the video and recall terminologies like IP address, hardware address, I hope you have recalled the terminologies. Okay, we'll start off with address mapping. Delivery of a packet to a host or to a router requires two levels of addressing. Two levels of addressing includes logical addressing and physical addressing. Why do we need these two levels of addressing? First, internet is made up of combination of different physical networks. The devices like router and host are identified at network layer by their logical addresses. And at physical layer, these devices are addressed by their physical addresses. So, when a packet starts its journey from source to the destination, it has to pass through different physical networks. We need to be able to map a logical address to its corresponding physical address and vice versa. Why we should be able to map these addresses? Because suppose we have a packet which is at a network layer, so it may pass through different physical networks before reaching its destination. Different kind of physical networks are there, like Ethernet and Apple Talk or Local Talk, which is developed by Apple. On the same line, we can say a packet traveling through an Ethernet network may encounter the two different protocols at network layer. The two different protocol may be, first is IP and second may be IPX. So the mapping between the logical address to the physical address can be done using static mapping and dynamic mapping. In static mapping, a table is created and the table is stored on each machine on the network. But this has some limitations, because whenever a mobile computer moves out of a network, its hardware address changes. Whenever the machine's network interface card is changed, its hardware address changes. Static mapping table must be updated periodically. This could affect the network performance. The another mapping style is dynamic mapping. In dynamic mapping, whenever a machine or source machine, we can say, has a destination machine's IP address, in that scenario, the source machine will use a services offered by ARP. ARP is nothing but a protocol used to find the physical addresses from the logical addresses. In dynamic mapping, two protocols are used to map the logical addresses to physical addresses. The first protocol is address resolution protocol, which maps logical addresses to physical addresses, and the second protocol is reverse address resolution protocol, which maps physical addresses to logical addresses. In this diagram, figure number 1, you can see the position of ARP in TCP/IP protocol suite. ARP in TCP/IP protocol suite accepts the logical addresses from a internet protocol and map those logical addresses to to corresponding physical addresses. Once ARP map those addresses, that mapping or that physical address is passed on to the data link layer. Okay, we'll see now how the address is mapped. That is how the physical address is mapped to a logical address. Suppose system A wants to find out the hardware address or physical address of system B. System A knows the logical address of system B, which is 141.23.56.23. In this scene, system A will generate the ARP request. In ARP request, IP address of system A, physical address of system A, and IP address of system B is included. As the physical address of system B is not known, that request message or packet will be broadcasted on a network. Once that message is broadcasted on the network, every machine on the network will receive and process that request packet. But only system B, which is a target destination or intended destination, will respond with a reply packet. In a reply packet, the IP address of system B and physical address of system B is included. The reply packet is a unicast message because the system B already knows the system A's IP address and physical address. Now we'll see the packet format of address resolution protocol. The first field in a packet format is hardware type. This field is a 16-bit field which defines the type of physical network. For Ethernet network, this field contains value 1. The second field is protocol type. This is also a 16-bit field. This field defines the type of protocol used. If the protocol used is IPv4, it will contain a value which will be different from IPv6. The third field is hardware length. This field is an 8-bit field. This field defines the length of hardware addresses. The next field is protocol length. This field defines the length of logical addresses. For IPv4, this field contains a value of 32. The next field is operation code. This field is a 16-bit field. This field indicates whether the packet is a request packet or reply packet. If the packet is a request packet, then this field contains value 1, and if the reply is to be sent, that time this field contains value 2. The next field, sender's hardware address. This field is a variable length field. This field contains the source hardware address. The next field is sender IP address. This field contains the source IP address. The target hardware address. Next field is target hardware address. This field contains the target physical address, but this field is only present in the reply packet. The last is target IP address. Last field is target IP address. This field contains the IP address of a target machine. Once the ARP maps logical addresses to corresponding physical addresses, then the packet from network layer is passed on to a data link layer, where it is encapsulated in a frame. In figure 4, you can see that how the ARP request message or reply message is encapsulated in a frame. The type field, this type field indicates the data contained in this data field is ARP request or reply packet. These are the references. Thank you.